Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Gavin. Thank you very much for stopping by. Today we're continuing to look at the victims and maybe victims of the Zodiac Killer. Today we're looking at a case that has been covered by myriad media outlets because it's widely believed, though never confirmed, that the victim is an early victim of the Zodiac Killer. This victim is, of course, 18-year-old Riverside City College freshman Cheri Jo Bates. Cheri Jo Bates, by all accounts, was an outgoing and friendly girl. She was an honor student in high school, active in student government, and a varsity cheerleader. After graduation from Ramona High School, she enrolled at Riverside Community College, which was about a 10-minute drive from her home. She worked part-time at Riverside National Bank. In the afternoon of October 30th, 1966, around 4:30 to 5 o'clock, Cheri Jo left her home to go to the college library to study and check out some books. Prior to leaving, she phoned a co-worker to ask if she had seen a term paper bibliography that Bates had misplaced. The co-worker said she had not seen it, to which Cheri Jo replied, "Now I'll have to start all over on my note cards." An eyewitness later told investigators that they had seen Cheri Jo drive her Volkswagen Beetle in the direction of Riverside Community College around 6:10 p.m. When Cheri Jo's father returned home after work that night, he found a note taped to the refrigerator which said, "Dad went to RCC Library." According to witness statements, Cheri Jo Bates studied at the library until it closed at 9 o'clock p.m. Her father waited the entire night for his daughter to return home. Sometime in the early hours, he phoned Cheri Jo's friend, Stephanie. He was told she wasn't there and that she had plans to study at the library that night. When Cheri Jo didn't arrive by early morning, he filed a missing person report with the Riverside Police Department. It was filed at 5:43 a.m. At approximately 6:28 on the morning of October 31st, 1966, just 45 minutes after the missing person report was filed, Cheri Jo's lifeless body was discovered on the grounds of Riverside Community College by a groundskeeper named Cleophas Martin. She was face down on a gravel path between two unoccupied houses close to the library parking lot where she had parked her Beetle the previous evening. She was dressed in the same long-sleeve, pale yellow print blouse and faded red capri pants she had been seen in the previous day. Her woven straw bag lay partly beneath her. Cheri Jo had been repeatedly stabbed in the chest and left shoulder and had slashing wounds on her face and neck. There was evidence that she had put up a fight against her assailant, scratching him with her fingernails and tearing off his wristwatch, which was found with a broken strap 10 feet from her body. The watch was an inexpensive Timex, which had paint splattered on it. Investigators also found a shoe print that they tracked to shoes produced by prisoners of Leavenworth and was sold exclusively in military stores. Cheri Jo's Beetle was parked just 75 feet from where she was found. The ignition wiring had been pulled loose. The key was in the ignition. At autopsy, numerous fragments of skin and brown hair were recovered from beneath Cheri Jo's fingernails. She had not been robbed, nor had she been sexually attacked. On November 29, 1966, two identical typewritten letters were received by the Riverside Police Department and the editorial office of the Press Enterprise, the local daily newspaper. The unknown author described in detail how he had first disabled Bates' car before allegedly watching her repeatedly attempt to switch on the ignition until the battery had drained of power. He had then claimed that he had offered her assistance, saying his own vehicle was farther down the street. After the two had walked a short distance from her car, he said to her, "It's about time." Cheri Jo replied, "About time for what?" To which he replied, "About time for you to die." In December of 1966, a strange poem was found written on the underside of a desk inside the library at Riverside Community College. The poem depicts a violent scene describing the death of a woman. Because two initials, R and H, have a striking resemblance to known handwriting of the Zodiac Killer, many have theorized that Cheri Jo Bates is one of his early victims. When one also considers that in the confession letter, the author states that Cheri Jo Bates is not the first, many citizen detectives have ascribed the killings of other victims in Southern California to the Zodiac. I'm curious what you think. Was Cheri Jo Bates a Zodiac Killer victim? Was she his first? Or were others such as Johnny and Joy Swindle and Ray Davis? Let me know in the comments below. Whether it was the Zodiac Killer or not who ended the life of Cheri Jo Bates, one thing is certain. Her killer has never been caught. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you liked what you saw, please subscribe to my channel. And if you have any comments or questions, please leave them below.